The ACT Party is marking 25 years in Parliament. But although the party's riding high in the polls at the moment, Sir Roger Douglas's brainchild hasn't had the easiest of political rides. Shortly, we will speak with party leader David Seymour. But first, here's Connor Stirling on a wild quarter century.
Tonight, Sir Roger is on the comeback.
1993, and controversial former Labour Finance Minister Sir Roger Douglas and National Cabinet Minister Derek Quigley had a new political vehicle, initially coy about the move.
Do you rule out a return to politics, sir?
I've got no intention of returning to politics at this point of time.
It would end up being another year before ACT, the party, was formed.
You're going to have a party that will develop out of the Association of Consumers and Taxpayers.
While Douglas led the party from the inception, Richard Preble would take the reins in 1996.
I'm told that I'm very likely to win.
A fierce fight in the seat of Wellington Central. Ultimately resulting in a Preble win, meaning ACT qualified for a healthy 8 MPs. 99 and 02 were ACT's high watermark with 9 MPs, but from there the wheels started to fall off the bus. Wayward MP Donna Awatiri Huata was suspended in 2003 amid multiple allegations of misuse of taxpayer money.
I'm extraordinarily sad that they're going to take that step to suspend me.
Preble would resign the leadership in 2004, MP Rodney Hyde stepping into his shoes.
Thank you, everyone, for coming along.
He'd go on to win the Epsom seat from National in 2005, one that ACT has held ever since. The use of his yellow jacket attracted the interest of the Electoral Commission and police in 2008, the Hydemobile not so much. The perk buster was himself busted the following year, using taxpayer funds to take his partner on overseas trips. But Hyde did have some wins, pushing to create the Auckland Supercity as local government minister. By now, ACT had 5 MPs, but just one would throw it into a tailspin. David Garrett suggested unfit parents should be sterilised, but then a previous conviction of assault in Tonga emerged. And while not convicted on this,
I obtained the birth certificate of a child born around the time I was born, but who died in infancy.
He'd later resign. A clumsy coup saw former National leader Don Brash take over from Rodney Hyde, hours after becoming a party member. A bewildered-looking Hyde holding it together as his friend tore strips off.
I'm saying this in front of you, Fran, but I mean, to some extent, he's been the victim of a media witch hunt.
The infamous cup of tea between John Key and Epsom candidate John Banks dominated the lead-up to 2011 as a signal to National supporters to back ACT over the National candidate. Brash would resign on election night, with Banks the only MP returned. The former Auckland mayor wouldn't last the term as a minister, standing trial for filing a false electoral return, although the conviction would later be overturned. Charter schools survived the election, however, 10 operating at their peak. 2014 went much the same for ACT. New and politically inexperienced leader Jamie White failed to win a list seat. Through the years of turbulence, David Seymour twice ran unsuccessful races in Auckland seats and spent 5 years working for a Canadian think tank.
The public health benefits of sanitation that we get from sewers, high-value public works like that make taxes seem trivial.
But in 2014, he got the chance to run in Epsom.
Hi. 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 Hi.
And campaigned well enough to become ACT's sole MP and then leader. Seymour tried all sorts to build awareness of the party, but the results for the party in 2017 were still dire. The polls started to turn for ACT in 2019 through Seymour's opposition to gun law changes. He also pushed through the end-of-life choice bill, 65% of voters ticking yes for it in last year's binding referendum. That same election, ACT won 10 seats off the back of a disaffection on the right with both the government and National. And with polls of late showing the party could do even better, David Seymour is now second only to Jacinda Ardern as preferred Prime Minister. The question now, can ACT hold it together until 2023?